spots. All over the place. Jane.
Oh, well.
Some people just don't know their place in the world.
Oh my, oh my. Now, I've seen this face, so yes, hooray! What can I do for you today? My wares it is you want to see. I promise you, they'll bring you glee.
Walk blessed.
Listen, my child, and always remember the tale that struck fear in the hearts of so many. Summer it was, the day had just broken.
There you are. Good. What? No, on the contrary. Even though us voices have a lot of privileges within the Relata, we're still under constant observation, just like the Scions and the Acolytes. If I were to leave town without any reason, that would raise more suspicion than just dropping off the grid for a couple of hours down here. Well, that's the plan. But as I said, We will have to discuss a couple of things first. And please listen carefully, even if it sounds boring. If we blow our cover, then it will not just be the end of our plan, but also the end of the two of us. So, the Ralata has a holy scripture called the Ralas, or the Book Out of the Ashes. Its verses are the commandments of every Ralaim. It affects you because there are a couple of rules that you have to abide by once we're inside the temple. To infringe them is a crude sign of disrespect, and no mercenary who values his life would do that. In other words, if we want nobody to get wind of our plan, you'll need to fit in. Number one, never talk to an acolyte, or voice, or seer, if they don't address you first. As a mercenary, you're at the bottom of the hierarchy, on one level with the Scions. By their garments. Scions wear plain robes, and sometimes hoods. Acolytes wear the purple robes of the Ralata with their distinctive sun pattern. Seers wear similar robes, only more ornate. Voices wear the same armor that I wear. Rule number two, wear this, or a helmet, whenever you enter the temple. The Ralata detests the display of the body, as all corporeality. Nobody will attack you if you enter the temple unveiled, but it will make people suspicious. And finally, rule number three, do not openly talk about the Father. It's considered blasphemy. You most likely won't see him before the expedition anyways. The Ralaim down there that have been committed to the Ralas for 20 years now and never saw him in person. How would I know? It's a rule. And we all know how much religious people love following rules without questioning them. I'm sure the Father had his reasons. I guess I saw him more than once as he experimented on my body as a child. But if you're referring to my time at the Ralata, yes, I have. Different. A lot more different from how you would probably picture him. Yeah, one more thing. In case the first seer asks, you contacted me, not the other way around. You heard the rumor that the Father is looking for the lost pages, and a man named Rezio Doran gave you the tip about Carlion. You then contacted me and the false dog, and we went to get the pages together. Either way, enough of the talking. I informed the first seer of our coming, and like any sleeper, you will be tested by another voice in front of the temple. A person who hasn't seen the truth yet. In other words, everybody who's not a Ralaim. Follow me.
Well, well. The venerable Sunchild graces us with its presence. Come to gawk at the people worse off than you.
That's a nice dress you're wearing there, Sunchild. I'd be careful. Some people down here would kill for something like that.
Some people just don't know their path.
Thank you.
populace, my dame. Please, the Lord will redeem you for your kindness.
Would you look at that? A fear from the surface. Want a word of advice? Play by the rules.
Right. Almost there.
Huh?
What? That's a bloody stupid question. Okay, let's assume for a moment that we don't intervene and kill the father on the expedition. There are three possible scenarios to how this visit to the Room of Paintings would go down. Number one, it goes wrong and he and whoever follows him inside all die. This is the only case where you're right. Number two, he succeeds and actually manages to separate his mind from his body. Then we'd have a spectral murderer floating through the world possessing powers we can't even begin to imagine. Number three, the temple turns out to be a dead end and he returns to the Undercity. Then we might have missed the only chance to even get close enough to kill him. You get my point? It's too much of a risk to sit on our hands and hope scenario number one happens.
Sunchild.
Well, exhausting to watch us working our asses off, Sunchild.
Yes.
Brother Sorrow.
Brother Wrath. From ashes to blood, from blood to liberation. Is this the sleeper?
Yes.
She knows the rules?
Of course.
Good. Hold still. Interesting. You may enter.
Thank you, brother.
Father's blessings.
Well, that was strange.
Yeah, as if.
Ah, right. The short version. Once you devote your life to the Relas, you need to take on a new name. The name of your biggest vice in your life before the Awakening. Relaim always call each other by their new names, but we voices often use our dead names in the outside world. Hardly. Most people don't like talking about their lives before the Relata. Every emotion is a weakness. Joy, greed, lust, scorn. According to the Relas, everything that is human is another obstacle on the way to transcendence. This man, he wasn't just any voice. He was the Father's right hand. Brother Sorrow. Most Relaim do. Complete veiling isn't required, but it's considered a sign of religious devotion. I know. He's always been like that. But don't underestimate him. This man is a monster. I once saw him fight four thugs at once who thought it was a good idea to rob a voice of the Father. He decapitated one of them, broke another one's face, and cut down the remaining two with a single swing of his sword. Yes.
Rialta Shara.
They will never understand, brother. You should stop agonizing.
Pity. He was a good man.
My family.
wrong. They were. You are Ra'laim now, and Transcendence is near. So we are the only family you need. So just burn these letters, meditate, and perform your duties. Now isn't the time to stray from the Ra'las.
First Seer. From ashes to blood, from blood to liberation.
Ah, Brother Wrath. Is this our visitor?
Yes, First Seer. She helped me find the lost pages.
Interesting. Show me. Interesting. Tell me, how did you know that the Father is looking for these? I see. And how did you meet Brother Wrath? Also through your contact? It is indeed. Well then, I am Brother Longing, or to you, the First Seer. I assume Brother Wrath promised you a reward for these.
I have 300 pennies.
The mercenary, good. Then go up to the tower and talk to Sister Envy. She will pay you. Brother Wrath, will you escort our guest back outside?
If that is your wish, then yes, First Seer.
What do you mean by that?
I was thinking... irrelevant. Father's blessings, First Seer. Thank you for your time.
Speak.
Well, the expedition. You said that the Father ordered you to find capable mercenaries. Treasure hunters.
I understand. You think she'd be a fitting candidate. She's an arcanist, isn't she?
Correct. And one who knows her craft. At least judging from what I saw.
Your aura is remarkable. It's true. Fine then. We actually have enough mercenaries already, but you seem to be more capable than the scum that usually runs the Undercity's alleys. However, before I recommend you to the Father, I want you to prove yourself. Brother Greed. Sister Pride, is she still in the Light Grove? Good. Then escort this woman into the Dark Valley. I want you to kill someone for us. Sister Pride. A voice who has betrayed us. Bring me her heart, and I'll consider recommending you to the Father. An expedition will be taking place soon, and we are still looking for capable mercenaries. As I said, she betrayed us. I believe my instructions were quite clear. Correct. She fled into a cave, probably hoping that we wouldn't find her there. Brother Greed will show you the way. Good luck. And you, Brother Wrath, will stay. There is something we need to discuss.
option.
All you got?
Just you. Just a scratch.
First of the Golden Moon, 8233. I can't bear it any longer. Father, Malphus, Fate, or whoever is listening, save me, or I will break. I will run, far away from this temple, far away, somewhere where nobody knows me, and where nobody sees me, and where I see nobody. Forgive me, Father. I need to leave. Or I will break.
Just a scratch, like the bite of a flea. Lucky.
are you? No, wait. Don't say anything. You're my punishment, aren't you? You're here to kill me. The faces. I just couldn't bear them any longer. I couldn't. None! At first, I thought it would pass, you know? That it's just a disease, like the fever. But it didn't. It only got worse. First this strangeness, then the faces. This feeling that I wasn't myself, that Sister Pride, Nessa, is only a puppet who thinks she is real. Me, my name, before the Father showed me the Ralas. It started 2 years ago. Sometimes, when I talk to people, their faces began to run off. Like color. Like wax. At first, I thought I was ill, so I drank grunt root every day, but it never got better. Only worse. Everything started to melt. First the nose, then the eyes, then the mouth. Until there was nothing left but a smooth, egg-shaped piece of skin. Yes, it doesn't help with the strangeness, but at least I don't have to see faces anymore. No. No, of course not. Because nobody could find out. Had they found out, then the Father would have left me behind on the Day of Transcendence. And I couldn't let that happen. Don't you understand? I couldn't. Why? Because I was weak. Angry and weak. I thought, if only I fled far away from the Father, then the faces would return. But they didn't. Of course they didn't. Because I was the problem to begin with. My faith was too weak. My devotion to the Ralas too little. And that is why I need to die. I finally accepted it. Everything. All this time. I was a bad Ralayim. I sinned, again and again. I succumbed to my body, just as the sleepers do. And it corrupted my mind. Of course you don't, because you're a sleeper. Don't be. It's what I want.
just a scratch.
Of the Conquering, 8233. I'm going crazy, and they all know. They know, but they act like they don't. But what can I do? It's not my fault. I didn't want to be this way. I didn't. I need to think, and pray. It will get better. It will.
sleeper. Do you have a second? What? No, to that lovely wall behind you. Come, follow me. There's something we need to talk about.
Watching you, Sleeper. Always.
All right. This is better. You're a mercenary, aren't you? You're the one who found the missing pages. Well, Kaz, your help. What do you mean? Of course we are. Though it might be wise not to go around telling everyone. You as a sleeper are frowned upon. I'd rather not. You get the point. Simple. I want you to find something for me. Relics. Old civilizations. Collectibles. In return, you'll be paid generously. Guess what? Not all of us grew up in rat shit in Guano. I'm not from the Undercity. Quite the opposite, actually. I'm of Sublime Path. Well done. Why did I leave my oh-so-glorious future among the Arc Bourgeois behind me? Because it's nonsense. Empty, asinine nonsense. Just like that clergy's blathering about Malthus and the righteous path. The bourgeois try to drown the pointlessness of their existence in costly jewelry, powdered wigs, and Aurazelian brandy. Whereas the godlands tell each other and the populace lies about the oh-so-glorious eternal paths, where we can all lick honey off a virgin's teat, if only we're docile and subservient enough while we're alive. I don't have parents anymore. The Relata is my family now. But yes, my breeders know very well where I am, and they have tried to end my folly more than once. I haven't heard from them. However, since Brother Greed sent the two bullies they hired to bring me back to the Upper City back with their arms and legs broken, do, which doesn't prevent the Scion from stashing away a pouch of pennies for a rainy day, does it? Oh, and just how am I supposed to do that? Should I just strip off my robes and sort out of here like Sister Pride did? Forget about it, Sleeper. One who accepts the Relas walks it for the rest of his life. And even though I'm grateful for your spiritual advice, I didn't ask for your opinion, but for your services as a mercenary. Anything related to the old civilizations. Starling technology, Pyrian pottery. You get the idea. It won't be to your disadvantage. You can count on that. Just come back here once you've found something, and I'll buy it for a price none of the merchants will offer you. Understood? Good. I'll be waiting. Yeah? Had any luck?
brings you here? Show me 300 pennies. And just what in the Father's name did you do to earn such copious pay? Impressive. Here's your money. Good luck. Not much, but if it's scrolls and potions you're after, I might be able to help. Here, take a look.
Would you look at that? The mercenary returns. Show me. Interesting. Well then, you upheld your end of the bargain, so I'll do the same. I don't care. She gave herself to the Ralas, to the Father, and she betrayed us. The punishment for this is death. End of story. The Father will. I will put forward my recommendation. We will contact you once he has made his decision. Now leave.
I don't believe that. He wouldn't just relate the Cheryl.
Maybe I did.
You know why we're here.
Maybe he was like Sister Pride after all.
Don't say that. You know that's not true.
You're right. I just hope we'll find him.
I beg you, brother, just 5 minutes.
No.
But I am ready. I can feel it, don't you understand? And if only the Father could see me now, he'd see it too. Please, Brother Sorrow, I know that the last step is near. I want to be there when it's done.
No.
You'll see. You'll bloody see, all of you.
Go.
Rialta Shara.
Move along.
Would you look at that? A visitor from the surface.
Hey! You there! Wait! I think I have a letter for you. At least I think it's you. You look just like the Meister told me.
Don't you fear it?
Well, the Meister also said you'd pay me 10 pennies for the delivery. He didn't have any coin.
I have to remember that.
Did you kill her? Good. That's good. You know, Nessa joined the Relata only shortly after me. She was an orphan, too. We even shared the same bunk bed for a year or so. And now she's dead. That feels strange. Close. I didn't say we were close. She was a murderer. Just like all those lunatic bastards. I would have cut her throat myself without a moment's hesitation had our plan demanded it. Faces. Huh. Now, we wait until we hear back from the first seer. If we're unlucky, that's where our plan will end. If the father is not interested in your services, there's nothing we can do. However, there's something else I might need your help with in the meantime. 250 pennies. More than enough. It has to do with my past, with the refuge. Yeah. I told you that Shagun, the matron of the house, knew about the abductions, didn't they? That she sold us? Well, I only learned that recently. I used to think that the Relata forced Shagun to give us away. And even now, there's still a part of me that wants to believe it. The reason why I'm going back to the refuge is that I want to know for certain. I want to know how rotten a soul Shagun really was. And who knows, maybe we'll also find more about what the father actually did with us children. More about the experiments. I hope so. It was closed down after the flesh maggot plague killed Shagun, so her documents might still be there. Thing is, ever since the Red Madness, the place has been crawling with lost ones. Exactly. I'd probably be able to do it myself, but now is the wrong time to take unnecessary risks. So, let's meet at the marketplace, right in front of Zorgbrand and Sons. I'll make some preparations.